Giovanni Segura is still recuperating from his fight against Brian Valoria. Valoria won that fight in 8 rounds. I'm here at the Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys talking to boxing trainer George Diaz, who sparked both of them. Before the fight, Giovanni Segura looked like this was an easy victory for him. He's on the rise. People will tell me that he's among the best pound-for-pound fighters. Brian Valoria, just a year ago, they said they were saying, oh, he had a great career time for him.
Yeah, he got stopped, and then I think he got knocked out in the last round.
The Hawaiian punch.
And he got sent to the hospital. I think and this was in the Philippines, I think.
Yeah, no, you're talking about the last fight that Valoria won, Segura's in the hospital. I'm talking about Brian a year ago. They said his career's over.
Yeah. Way. You know, I met Brian before he was world champion. He was still undefeated. I used to spar with him.
Where? Here?
At Wild Card. This is when I was kind of like the first couple times that I used to spar at the Wild Card. He gave me trouble because I wasn't used to sparring smaller guys. The biggest two losses in my career, in my boxing career, that I consider losses were to smaller fighter that...
How do you explain that? That's supposed to be easier for you. You have the reach.
But at that time, I wasn't really sparring guys that were 113, 114 pounds, 112 pounders. I wasn't used to that. My eyes weren't adjusted to those type of fighters of that size, so because most of the guys were my size or maybe a little bigger.
That's where usually the opposite. Usually say that guy was just too big for me. You don't hear guy was too small for me, therefore you beat me. But George, I gotta ask you this. Now his career is back. Brian Valoria, he won, he earned it. He's 31 years old. Who does he fight next?
Those weight divisions are very hard to really point out to have him fight big name because not. Just to no disrespect to any fighter of any other country, but they're not fighting in the U.S. That's the reason fighters not being exposed. That's the reason I've always said the local networks from should expose fighters even from other countries just to see who they are. To market those small. The smaller fighter have always had a hard time making a name for himself. For biggest example, Ricardo Finito Lopez. Great fighter from out of Mexico, 105, 108 pounder, fought a lot. He fought. He wasn't fighting often, but he fought. He held the title for the longest. Didn't get exposure. One of the fighters that really made an impression that smaller fighters started making money was Michael Carbajal because he started knocking guys out.
Like Donaire is doing now.
Yeah, but Donaire still is a little bit in the higher
weight. Of
weights.
Course, yeah, I know.
These guys were 108, 100, 105, 108.
Because when people see a guy that's 108, they don't think he's a fighter, George. They think he's a soccer player. They think he's a jockey.
They think he's a jockey. Because they don't think that they're a threat. They look at him, he's a slow, small guy. When I was in high school, I remember guys telling me, you're a boxer? You're too small to be a boxer. But I was 110 pounds. It wasn't my fault.
They don't understand it.
You know,
a boxing champion came to this country, a friend of mine, and they harassed him at the airport. They didn't believe that was his belt. They go, what is this, you bought it? He goes, no, I'm a champion.
Yeah.
Because they want everyone to look like Mike Tyson or like Klitschko.
Giovanni Segura, one of the hardest punchers I've been in the ring with, for us.
And you sparked Pacquiao. Does he hit harder than Pacquiao?
I'm not going to say he is hard in pocket, but I'm going to say he's one of the guys that actually hit me the hardest just because I think I underestimated him for his size. He actually hit me on the nose and basically, I don't know if he fractured it, but he hit me up in the nose so with a bloodbath that day of sparring, but I didn't want to quit. I told my trainer, don't stop it.
And that's the day you started looking like?
Like who?
Edwin Valero?
My nose.
Now, who do they always say you look like?
You go down the list, who can you say? Edison Miranda told me I look like Edwin Valero when I let my hair grow. Somebody back a few years ago when I was a lot skinnier told me I look like Paulie Malignaggi. That's when he wasn't world champion yet. We looked at the screen, we saw this guy. I'm like, who the hell is this guy?
His career is back. He wins his next fight. He's a champion. Everything could go He's already a household name.
Yeah.
Everybody will fight him, and he'll make money. They'll make money.
Yeah, and that's great for a fighter that went to a hard. He became world champion, went to a hard fight, and then all of a sudden bounces back. You got to give him credit.
He fought Cotto. He fought Amir Khan. Amir Khan destroyed everyone until the last fight with Peterson, which I still think he won, mm-hmm. but a lot of people like yourself think he didn't.
Yeah, because, you know, I saw one of your interview with Brandon Krause from Outlaws Boxing, you know, and then, you know, I know him very well, great guy. He said the same thing, you know, but he saw it, he turned off the audio, you know. Sometimes people get caught up what they listen. They see it, but they're listening. So people kind of like get to make the two each other, you know, the commentator was saying con this, con that, con this, con that. And, you know, and people start looking, kind of go towards con. If you take out the volume, just look at the fight. For me, Peterson landed the better punches. You know, he was the aggressor. He was trying to make the fight. You know, Khan was just coming in throwing it. But, you know, he was throwing a lot of punches. Everything looked flashy. But like I said, this is not the amateurs. This is the professional league. You know, you throw punches to do damage, not to create points.
Let me ask you this question. Mm-hmm. 108 pounds, 106 pounds, 98 pounds. Are those fighters lethal weapons or are they jockeys? Could they only be a threat? If they walk down the street and you're 108 pounds and you're a star boxer, can you destroy folks in the street?
Oh, yeah. They're lethal still.
So why do people think they're jockeys?
Because they're small. They look like they're malnourished. You know, they feel like they don't feed them. You know, it's, you know.
Pacquiao won his first title at 108.
112, 108, 112. Yeah, 112? I can't remember. Yeah, okay. 100, you know, but yeah, 112. You're right. Oh, Ellie, you're following on boxing.
Leave it at that. There you have it, George Diaz. I finally got one right. For ESNewsReport.com, I'm Isaac Back reporting.